Today is BMS update day. So today I am having my BMS updated, that's the battery management system done by Renault Lookers Stockport. They are hopefully coming to pick the car up in a minute from me and take it for the BMS update. This is the before video and I'm going to do an after video of the difference. I charged the car fully on Sunday night and this was the mileage it was showing. I'll display it up on the side here. That is the mileage it showed fully charged. Now, that's one indication that you need a BMS update if the gasometer, the charge meter, is way low it should be for the time of year. You'll always show less miles in the winter and more like miles in the summer because the battery pack is warmer obviously in the summer and performs slightly better than when it's in the cold. If your battery is not behaving the way it should, you need a BMS update. The BMS update, battery management system update, will change a few things. It'll change the battery curve, how the battery charges. It manages the battery charging better to better protect the battery pack. The reason why your mileage decreases so much prior to the new BMS firmware update is because the battery is trying to overcompensate to protect the battery pack, because it thinks the battery pack is way worse than what it should be. It's trying to overcompensate. So you're charging the car, it thinks there's a problem with the battery, it reduces the state of health of the battery. So if you've got a CAN ZE, that's the other way of checking the state of health, basically if you need the BMS update, you can even look directly at the firmware if you've got a diagnostic tool, or you can see the state of health. If the state of health is extremely low, 70s, 80s, then it's more than likely not had the BMS update. If after the BMS update, you'll notice that the state of health will jump up. Some have jumped up to 95%, some have jumped to 100%. Basically, it will improve the state of health rapidly because it's showing the true capacity of your battery. That's what the BMS update does. It shows the true state of health of the battery system, the actual state of health, rather than what the computer thought it was previously with the old firmware. So you do need this firmware update. It is good for the battery pack. It will more than likely improve the life of the battery pack because it's sorting out that charge curve, which was incorrect, and also sorting out the way it manages the power. It also, I believe, sorts out the regen, the way the car regens itself. Now, what will be interesting to see for me is before 99% to 100% could take up to 2 hours. Now, after the BMS update, it should take between 10 and 45 minutes. That 2 hours, I'm intrigued to see, will it use less electricity at my home? Because it's still charging that 99 to 100% for 2 hours. There's no real charge there, but it's sucking electricity out of the grid because you can hear the motor whining. So will that change there, that noise, will that reduce my electricity bill? Of course it will, because it's pulling a draw out. So let's see how much my electricity reduces after the BMS update. So I'll say bye for now. I'll be back in a second for you, and I'll show you what the car looks like after the BMS update, and I'll also do a full charge. So I've just had a call off Renault Lookers to tell me the car's ready. So, not trusting main dealers, I asked them for two bits of vital information to prove that they've done it. Information number one I asked them for was to provide me the state of health of the battery now the update's been completed. The second piece of information I asked them for was the current firmware version of the BMS system. This was to confirm that they've actually done the job. I asked for either a screen print or a photo or a video, because they do videos now when they inspect your car, of the diagnostic equipment to prove that they've actually done the update. She said she'd ring me back and let me know. So she rings me back and I speak to a bloke this time, and he tells me that unfortunately that the update hasn't been applied because it's not applicable to my car. So I said it is applicable, I know it's applicable, I know the fault. I gave you the solution number, you've had the car for 6-7 hours. Why have you had 6-7 hours? You've not actually done anything. Basically all they did was wash my car and put it on a ramp and inspect it. They didn't carry out any of the updates, didn't ring me until 4 o'clock in the afternoon to tell me that the car was ready and finished. So I then explained to him that I gave him the solution number. He looks up on his computer and then suddenly tells me, yes, it is applicable to my car, but that is not an update, that is a solution. I said, yes, it's a solution to update the BMS, the battery management system, that looks after the state of battery. I said, my fault, all the faults on that solution number are the faults that my battery BMS is occurring. So my major problem is the 99 to 100% takes 2 to 3 hours. He then said that unfortunately he won't be able to do it today because it takes 4 hours, which I already knew this, which is why I gave them for the full day. So unfortunately for me, I've not had it done today. They are recollecting the car a week. So next week I should have the car done. So I'll do another video. So this video has highlighted some important issues regarding the BMS, which is when you book it into a dealer and you think you've had it done, don't presume it has been done, because some of them will say they've done it because originally they said my car's ready to pick up. Until I questioned the firmware to be supplied to me or the state of health of the battery to be supplied to me, not then until they admitted that the actual job hadn't been done. So it's good to check that they have actually done it. The best way to book your car in for the BMS update is tell them the symptoms it's happening and tell them, look, I know the solution number to fix the issue is this, and give them the solution number that's in the description at the bottom. That is the best way to get Renault dealer to fix it. Now, if you're taking it to a Renault owned garage, part of Renault retail, then they'll automatically do most of these updates as soon as the car comes in. But if you're taking it to a franchise dealer, which is why I've took it, they don't seem to sort of be in the same loop of information. Now, personally, Renault should just be updating all these information. They should send a service bulletin to all their Renault garages to say to update the BMS the same time as the software of the car every time a car comes in for a service. While they don't do this, it's absolutely mad. But thanks for watching the video this week. Next week there will be the after BMS update video. So this is part one of part two. Part two will be next week. So if you've enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel down at the bottom, and I'll see you again next week for another video. Thank you very much for watching. Goodbye.